But
let's shift a little bit. Talk about the physical changes a little bit more, because we were talking about before the podcast, like even some of the medical stuff, like we were talking about, you know, your doctors were talking about a possible hip replacement, you know, like talk about what's happened to you physically through this process of training for pole vault, and how did pole vault help you do that, you know, versus like, why didn't you just work out, you know, like talk about like the mentality before and after.
You know, I did work out, you know, I mean, I lifted weights and things like that, and I always thought I was in shape, you know, and when you talk to people that knew me, like, you know, mm-hmm. 3 years ago or 2 years ago, no one would have said that I was fat and overweight. You know, I generally looked like I was a decent in shape guy, and I had big arms and, you know, broad shoulders. And, you know, but I said, you know, I think I knew I had to lose weight. I knew just because of straight pole size that, again, I knew I couldn't grip high. You know, I never was a big vaulter, so I wasn't going to come out and, you know, hold 13 feet or something ridiculous. Right. And just from pure pole, I mean, they don't make a 200-pound, you know, 10-8 pole, you know. So you're okay, I'm going to have to lose weight. And, you know, I know the more weight I lose, the faster I could run. And, you know, I saw a couple videos of myself, and I'm like, wow, my knees are really low. And it just seemed that the more weight I lost, the better I felt. And then there was a reward. So, like, not only did I feel good, but I would jump better, you know. So then I'm like, well, okay, well, you know, if I lose a little more weight and maybe I get a little bit stronger, then I'll jump better. So, like, I think what pole vaulting really gave me was it gave me a reward for everything I did. Mm-hmm. So, like, you know, you lose weight, or you get your – maybe if you're a big lifter and you say, well, okay, I just benched 250 pounds. You know, and that was a milestone. Right. So maybe that motivates you. And for me, that's what pole vaulting did, was for everything that I did, the stronger I got, the faster I got, the more weight I lost, there was a reward. And that reward was I saw me jumping higher bars. I was executing things
better. But it's interesting you bring up weightlifting, and you know I love weightlifting. But, you know, it's funny, right? You could hit that mark in the bench, let's say, but you're not necessarily in better shape all the time.
Right.
You know, your lifting numbers can go up, but your body weight numbers can be going up. You could be putting on excess fat to, like, move that weight.
I was stronger when I was not training for pole vault. I was much stronger. If I look at what I benched back then, you know, and, you know, I lifted, you know, I worked out with a bunch of guys, and I was much, much stronger.
But were you healthier?
Nowhere near. But yeah. I'm not benching close to my weight. I couldn't do as many pull-ups as I could do now. I mean, I can do push-ups now till you just tell me to stop.
Right.
You know, but like I said, pole vaulting kind of gave me that reward. And I feel much healthier because of it. And when I don't jump, now, as I said, we were just talking before, is, you know, I haven't jumped in a month. Mm-hmm. I gave my son a little bit of time off. And, you know, in return, I wound up giving myself time off. Because, you know, it's not fun for me to jump if he doesn't jump.
Right.
So, you know, if he's jumping and my daughter's jumping, then I jump with them.
Yeah.
But, you know, I haven't jumped in a month and I don't feel healthy. Like, it feels like I'm missing it. I'm almost having an itch. I'm like, okay, I want to start getting back in it again. But it gave me that check to say is, and I knew right away, we talked earlier, is, you know, I weigh myself every day now, you know, because it took me so much to get down. I don't want to slip. I don't know how I got to 200 pounds. You know, you know, I always remember being 160, and then all of a sudden I was 175.
Well, I was using the bank account analogy, but that's perfect, right? Like, some people, they can't keep their bank account right. They're always, like, you know, losing all their money by the end of the month because, oh, $5 here, 20 bucks there. Oh, you know what? I'll put this on my credit card, da-da-da-da. And then at the end of the month, you're like, wait, where did all the money go? And it's like, well, if you're not keeping track of it day to day, that's what happens.
Right.
You have to keep track. And I think, you know, I'm not saying other people need to weigh themselves every day and this and that. But, you know, for you, that became something important, and that was a benchmark, and it really helped
you. It just keeps me close. I mean, you don't want to go into $20,000 in credit card debt.
Right.
You know, but, you know, okay, I can go a little bit in the hole. And, you know, it was funny. One of the guys who really inspired me was Carlton Huff, who's another Masters vaulter, and he's significantly older than I am. And, you know, I was like, listen, if this guy can continue jumping at his age, you know, this is ridiculous. And I should be able to jump higher than him, even though he's a better jumper and he's technically really proficient. I mean, just the age difference, there's no reason.
Right.
And he kind of gave me the mentality of, he goes, you know, you got to kind of train like a boxer. You know, I can't stay in peak physical shape, you know, all the time.
Right.
You know, I train up to things, and that's how Reno was. I remember when I made the commitment to go to Reno, my boss is a pretty big guy, and he knows the science of, like you, like the science of weightlifting. And I just said, you know, November comes, I go, you're going to start training me for you know, for Reno. And that gives me about 2 months or so to really start, you know, getting in shape.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
November 1st, I walked into work and he's like, all right, you know, 11:30, we're going to the gym.
Yeah.
You know, and, you know, I built up to that. And then, you know, I remember talking to you because I wanted to go to indoor nationals for masters. And I said I just couldn't maintain that level.
Right.
And I wasn't going to go and compete if I wasn't going to be able to maintain the level because I want to cheat. You know, as soon as
soon
as Reno was over, I went to the bar and I had, you know, my friends know me. I like foo-foo girly drinks. If it's got an umbrella and a piece of fruit in it, you know, that's what I want. You know, I want the sugar.
Yeah.
And I went to the bar and I said, you know, imagine I'm a 21-year-old girl and I'm at the bar for the first time. That's the drink I want.
Yeah.
You know, so, you know, I cheat and then, you know, then I work my way back. But, you know, I don't want to cheat so much that I can't get myself back or it's going to be such a hurdle to get myself back.
Right.
I mean, I remember last year, I mean, I was struggling, you know, to get under 170 pounds, you know, and I'm like, okay, that last five, you know, I was 175 and I'm like, okay, I want to get under 170. I want to get under 170. Yeah. And then all of a sudden, like, I couldn't do it. And then all of a sudden, like, you know, I started getting in better shape. And then all of a sudden I was under 170. And next thing you know, I was 160.
Right.
And like now I'm upset because, you know, I'm like 167 and I'm like,
wait,
160 was easy weight for me. And when I was cheating, I was getting to 165 and it was easy to drop back down again.
Yeah.
And again, the last competition, you know, I was 159 pounds.
Well, I feel like too, you know, and again, for people listening to the story, you know, if they think back to when you said that first month when you were over 200 pounds, you lost 30 pounds. I think initially when people are losing weight, it's easier to lose weight. But it's like if you keep at it for a long enough time period, that's what happens. You're going to have like those weight plateaus.
Right.
But if you just keep at it, you'll bust through and you'll keep going. You'll get to healthier and healthier weights. And obviously whatever weight is healthy for you personally, you know, everybody's got a different body. But yeah, I mean, to me, it's amazing because I still, like I said, I remember when you first started coming in and the physical shape you're in now. And to think, too, that you went from, you know, doctors saying that you're looking somewhere down the road having a hip replacement and now you feel great, right?
I used to play, you know, my son grew up and, you know, he played baseball. And I remember throwing a baseball with him in the yard. And, you know, as I would step forward, my knees would give out. You know, I have really bad knees. I've lived a hard life. You know, from the time I was 12 years old, I worked on construction sites and I was a mason's apprentice, you know, so a lot of bending over, a lot of, you know, we didn't do things the right way. You know, I kneeled on my knees on concrete and things like that. And like he would laugh at me, like he's a little kid and I would throw the ball at him and literally I would fall over, you know, because my knees would just give out. And like I said, then, you know, the doctors, he's like, it's really not your knees. It's really your hips. It's inevitable. You're going to have hip replacement. And now I just kind of laugh at him because I'm nowhere close. I don't have that problem anymore. My knees don't give out. I have no problem climbing stairs. And it was really, you know, because of the weight loss and because of pole vaulting, you know, that kind of kept me in that condition. And I feel so much the only thing my wife is happy about is that I don't snore anymore, which, you know, which
well, that's a big deal. Yeah. I mean, because the heavier you are, the more likely you are to snore. And then some people get so heavy, they need the CPAP machine and stuff like that. I think it's amazing, like, that, you know, our bodies can do almost anything. Like if you want it to fall apart, you could take it down that road. But if you want to keep it as best as it could possibly be, you can make dramatic changes to your body. And the thing that I love about pole vault, because even for me, I was up to 190 and, you know, I don't jump much now because I'm very busy. So I'll at least maintain my workouts. But like what got me to lose the weight was like, it was fun to jump. I was like, okay, I'm going to jump. And I'm gonna try to hit a lifetime best. I did the same thing, which fortunately I did. I was super pumped. But you know, that motivated me because the more I worked out, the better I would jump. And it, you know, it's like it's kind of like that carrot that pulls you along because the higher you jump, you're like, oh my god, I almost got that next bar too. You know, and you can see the push because now it's funny. Like you talk about how when you were jumping like 8, 6, 9, and you were like, I was like, what's your goal? And I was like, well, I think you could lifetime best. Well, now you've done that, and now we're talking about 13, maybe 14 feet, you know, which is like, I know maybe it sounds crazy, but it's like, one, it's a great motivator, you know, it's going to motivate the heck out of you, and two, it's fun. The process of building up to that, you know, and figuring out the puzzle pieces, you know, whether it's something technical, like I know for you, we've been talking a lot about your pole carry, you know, like that's one of the technical pieces for you that's huge. Then it's like, okay, well, what physical things can you do? What diet things can you do? And you keep working this puzzle where maybe to somebody who, you know, and if you think back to when you were out of shape, if I just said to you, hey, why don't you work out with me every day? You might have been like, eh,
Right.
You know, but it's weird. It transforms you, because hearing you talk now versus when you used to watch me work out, it's like a different mentality.